Hello, I'm John.
And I'm Diane.
And we are both vegans. There's something else we have in common. Both of us do not believe in
free will.
One of my favorite quotes is by Neil Donald Walsh, who said, "Life begins at the end of your comfort zone." Some of what you are going to hear in this video may make you feel a little bit uncomfortable, but I encourage you to stick with the video, watch it right to the end, even if it makes you feel uncomfortable, because you'll get information that can help you change your life for the better.
This isn't some woo-woo New Age theory. Some of the greatest thinkers throughout history have known that free will is an illusion. For instance, Albert Einstein.
Here's a book called The Myth of Free Will by Chris Evatt. And there's a quote by Albert Einstein. "Our actions should be based on the ever-present awareness that humans, in their thinking, feeling, and acting, are not free, but are as causally bound as the stars in their motion." The moment in time when you think you're making a choice is actually the moment in time when you're simply becoming aware of the choice that your brain made for you all on its own. And some people say, "Well, John, you are your brain." Okay, well, you didn't pick your brain. When you're born, you don't get to pick out a brain for yourself. You just get your brain from your parents, and they got their brains from their parents, and so on, back to the origin of life. And your life experiences, you get from everybody else, and you make all your choices based on your genetics and life experiences, all of which you got from others. So where's the freedom in that? Where's the free choice? There are no free choices. Every choice is caused by something. Every choice, just as, you know, this table can't lift up in the air all by itself. I have to lift it up. It has to have a cause. And you can't think a thought all on your own. Every thought has a cause.
You know, people sometimes say there's more to us than just genetics and life experiences. But really, think about it. I mean, what else is there? I can't think of a single thing. It pretty much just comes down to genetics and life experiences.
Yeah. In fact, it doesn't just pretty much come down to it. It only comes down to it. That's all there is. Some people say, "Oh, there's a soul or a spirit." And science has never proven that those things exist. And even if they did exist, okay, when did you pick your soul? When did you pick your spirit? You never did. We make choices, but we make our choices based on our genetics and life experiences. Different genetics and life experiences, different choices. Anytime someone makes a choice that you dislike, just think to yourself, "Well, if I had your genetics and life experiences, I would have made the same choice that you made. If we exchange all our atoms, I'd be you, and I'd be making all the same choices that you're making."
Accepting that free will is an illusion doesn't excuse bad behavior, it merely explains it. Of course, if someone does something to harm others, we have to do whatever we can to prevent that. We have to stop them. We have to find a way to make sure it doesn't happen again. But we don't have to hate them, and we don't have to look for retribution. We can merely look to find a way to perhaps heal, or in the worst case scenario, if someone simply cannot be stopped from harming others, they may have to be kept away from other people. And that's something that we can do, but we don't have to put them in a terrible place where their life is an absolute misery either.
Here's some food for thought. If free will is real, if people have completely free choices, why would anyone choose to molest a child? Why would someone choose to rape someone? Why would someone choose to become a serial killer? Why would someone choose to become addicted to gambling and lose everything, or become addicted to drugs or alcohol? Why would someone choose to become depressed, possibly so depressed that you're suicidal? Why would someone choose any of that? I am vegan because I practice the golden rule. I treat others the way I'd like to be treated. I wouldn't like for someone to kill me and eat me, so I don't kill and eat anyone else. I like when people treat me with respect, so I treat others with respect. And the reason I want to help people learn that free will is an illusion is because I want to help you to become better at feeling empathy for everyone. I'm tired of people saying really nasty, nasty things about their fellow earthlings. So next time you feel an urge to say something nasty, instead, kill them with kindness. Break the cycle of violence and anger and be nice to someone. If someone's mean to you, just think to yourself, "Well, if I had that person's genetics and life experiences, I would have made the same mean comment that person did. So I'm no better than that person. I am going to help that person by giving that person some positive life experiences. Be kind to that person. If you want to live in a world where we all respect each other, then respect everyone.
Similarly, why would someone choose to be homeless, to be outside, freezing cold, hungry? There are people that will say, hey, I worked hard for what I have. I pulled myself up by my bootstraps. You know, why can't these people do that? Why do they have to be lazy and doing nothing with their lives when they could be contributing to society? But really, that's just a way to look down on others. Had your life experiences led you in the direction they did, you would be exactly in their position.
Some people have said to me, hey, John, if there's no free will, then why bother? Why not just stay in bed all day? You know, if I'm not in control of my actions, then why do anything? Well, try that as an experiment. You know, next time in the morning, just instead of getting up out of bed, just stay in bed. Don't do anything. Well, guess what? After a while, you're going to get hungry and you're going to get up, and then maybe you'll want to do something because you're bored. And next thing you know, you're going to be just carrying on with life as you've been living. I don't believe in free will, and I don't feel that I'm responsible for my actions, but I'm not out there murdering people. I'm not raping people. I'm doing good deeds because I get pleasure from doing good deeds. I get pleasure from promoting veganism. I get pleasure from doing activism and doing my arts and making videos. I'm vegan not because I'm better than anyone else. I just got luckier. I was born with a brain that's good at feeling empathy, and I had life experiences which set me on the vegan path that made me want to be vegan. So now I'm vegan, and I don't look down on anyone who isn't vegan. Some people say that, well, if there's no free will, then I guess people can't choose to go vegan. Actually, it's the opposite. Because there's no free will, people can't choose to not go vegan. Consider this. Let's say, imagine we have three robots on the table here. And each robot was constructed a little differently, and each robot had different information fed into it. Then you ask the different robots for their opinions on different matters. Hey, Robot A, what do you think of this? Well, I think blah, blah, blah. Robot B, what do you think of this? I think blah, 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 blah. Robot C, what do you think of this? I think blah, 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 blah. They all gave you different answers, and they all think that they're coming up with these opinions all on their own. But you're looking at them, and you know they're only giving you these opinions because of the way they were constructed and the information that was fed into them. If I fed in different information, then they'd respond in different ways. So with people, they've been conditioned by the system of carnism to eat certain animals. Well, you need to give them life experiences that will make them want to be vegan. And for some people, it might take one heck of a lot of life experiences. Some people are early adopters like Diane and I, and veganism is not the norm yet, but we are vegan now because we're early adopters. Well, we can promote veganism and reach other early adopters until we get a critical mass of vegans. And the people who are just kind of go with the flow people, they're going to go vegan too because everyone around them is going vegan. For many years, we lived in tribes. And to survive, you didn't want to be the outcast. You could get kicked out of the tribe and die. And also, people wouldn't mate with you if you were the oddball. And so your genes would die out. So we kind of have that way of thinking of some people are afraid of being different. Well, we're not afraid of being different. Hey, Diane, you're not afraid of being different either.
Not at all. Have been all my life.
So, hey, we're vegan. So have some empathy for people who aren't vegan yet. Don't look down on them. Just help them. Give them life experiences. Share some delicious vegan food with them. Give them some vegan literature to read, some videos to watch. And we can plant lots of vegan seeds and inspire people to go vegan.
Some people say, save your tears for the victims. And you know, that's exactly the way I used to think. For most of my life, I believed that there were people in the world that were just plain evil, and that they really deserved whatever happened to them. Accepting that free will is an illusion has given me an incredible amount of peace of mind. Now, when I look at someone, I think, you know, this person could have been me, had my path. If I'd been on the same path they were, you know, from one place to another, I might have been this person. Therefore, I can't look down on them. I can't hate them. I can hate their choices, but I don't hate them.
Not only can letting go of the illusion of free will make it easier for you to feel empathy for others, but you'll also get better at feeling empathy for yourself. If you ever make a mistake and you do something terrible that you regret, just have some empathy for yourself and realize that you're not responsible for your actions. It's all just genetics and life experiences. And so that can help you to take it easy on yourself and not beat yourself up about things.
And I think that that's where we kind of run to a problem, because I think most people may be just hardwired into our, you know, who we are as people, that we like to feel proud of ourselves. You know, we like to look back on what we've done and think, look at all I've accomplished. I started out with so little and I've, you know, come so far. I've made so many choices and changes in my life that have made me such a better person than I am today. And that's pride, you know, and we all have that to some extent. But I think that pride can also be a negative thing if you're using it to say, hey, I'm better than you. Look what I did and look at you, you know. But what's the matter with you? Why can't you be more like me? That's never helpful. And I, you know, accepting that free will is an illusion can really help you with that. I genuinely believe that.
I think the world will be a better place in every way once we let everyone know that free will is an illusion. People will become way better at feeling empathy for each other. And you'll realize that as far as, for instance, fighting crime goes, right now the thought process is, well, we need more prisons and longer prison sentences and everything. But if you really want to get tough on crime, you have to get at the other ends and create a world where people don't want to commit crimes in the first place. We need to help each other. And everyone should be able to have a roof over their head and clean drinking water and food to eat. And we don't need people working 40 plus hours a week just so they can spend almost all their money on bills and on rent and food. Let's create a world where we can all be happy and have more time to do things that make us happy. Some people say, well, if we tell everyone free will is an illusion, you're not responsible for your actions, it's going to lead to chaos. Well, Diane and I don't believe in free will, and it's only made us better people in every way. We're not out there raping and pillaging. We're not serial killers or anything like that. We've just become better at being kind to people.
I'm not quite as far along as John is. I still struggle sometimes with the respect thing, and I can honestly say that I don't hate anyone, but I'm not quite at the I love everyone stage yet, but I'm working on it. I think that I want to be a better person, and I want to do my part to make the world a better place, and I think that we all do. And the best way to do that is to not hate others, but to try to help them.
If you watched this video to the end, thank you very much. If you didn't, I'm not angry with you. If I had your genetics and life experiences, I would have stopped watching the video too. If you don't like the video that we made, it's not our fault. Blame the universe. We're simply products of our genetics and life experiences. In conclusion, thank you very much for watching Go Vegan, and some final words from Diane.
Okay, liberation for animals, liberation for all people, liberation for all earthlings, and thank you for watching.